Hi, welcome back to social science class. I'm your Naveen. In previous class, we were discussing about the lesson by opposition of to British rule in Karnataka. Under that, we have discussed about the Hyder Ali and first Anglo-Mysore War. We know that the first Anglo-Mysore War ended with the treaty called Madras Treaty. After the first Anglo-Mysore War, there was a war between English and Hyder Ali, that is in the year of 1780 to 1784. That is, we are calling as the second Anglo-Mysore War. So we know the Madras Treaty had put the political development in South India on a temporary hold. British attempted to break Madras Treaty also. The Mahadev Rao, according to the first Madras Treaty, the concept was there that each should not wage a war. The if anyone has attacked Hyder Ali, means British has to come for the support. If British were fighting for the anyone, the Hyder Ali has to go for the support was there. But what happened, the Madhav Rao, who was a Maratha ruler, he attacked Srirangapatna with Maratha's army. Hyder Ali expected the British support him as per Madras Treaty. The British rejected the request of Hyder Ali, went against Madras Treaty. This has become the cause for the second Anglo-Mysore War. The British rejected the request of Hyder Ali and went against the Madras Treaty. Actually, Mahé, the French colony, was under the hold of Hyder Ali at that time. The British attacked Mahé and captured it. What are the Mahé was there? That is a British colony which was under the Hyder Ali. So British, what they have done, they have attacked the Mahé and they have captured it. The second Anglo-Mysore War started in the year of 1780. So here Hyder Ali gained upper hand in the previously. He captured many ports of Karnataka region. Kanchipuram was captured by Hyder Ali. The Mysore army reached till the Coromandel Beach. Up to Coromandel Beach, the Mysore army was reached. He also threatened the attack of Andivash and Velluru also. Vandivash and Vellore. An army was kept in stand by the British. It was led by the Sir Aircourt. The British army, what was they? That was carried by or the leaded by the Sir Aircourt. He followed the Hyder Ali army till Pondicherry. The French refused to support for the Hyder Ali against the British in here. Hyder Ali changed his strategy with his development. Hyder Ali was defeated in the battle which is called as Port Nova by British. The first I said the Hyder Ali was in the winner. He was supposed to win in the battle. The first he was we can say as he got a victory, but after what happened when the Sir Aircourt leaded the army, and that time the French also refused support for Hyder Ali. And in the battle which has held in the Port Nova, that is that became the Hyder Ali was defeated in Port Nova. But British they have suffered lot financial setback, that is in Pulicat and Solignuru. By ending here, the war was ended with the Salbai Agreement. The second Anglo-Mysore War ended with the Salbai Agreement. The British was successful winning over the Marathas and Nizamas of Hyderabad, their side. We can see here, always the British were using the cunningness policy. They took over our native kings in their hand. So they were attacking our other side. So Marathas and Nizamas were in the side of British. So Hyder Ali not able to do anything. And in the same time, in the 1784, the war has ended with the Salbei Agreement we were saying. So Hyder Ali lost his life, that is due to his illness. But the war was led by his son, that is called as Tipu Sultan. Who is this Tipu Sultan and all the things we can see? Tipu Sultan felt that the British are the major obstacles for his policy of expansion, so he tried to drive them out seriously. He became the ruler of Mysore after Hyder Ali's death. He understood the cunning policy of the British. He considered as his duty to drive the British out of India. He waged war against the British throughout his 17 years of rule. He had clearly understood the cunningness, strategy, clever manipulations of the British. He knew that hurting of the business interest of the British would weaken the political strength of the British. He tried to organize the enemies of the British into one group. He tried to break monopoly of the British over the trade with India. His main strategy, what was as Tipu was using, that not only polity, if they have to become politically weaker, means we have to concentrate more on what, that is a trade, because the trade purpose the British came, and if we make them financially burdened, automatically their strength is going to down. His ambition was like that. Sorry, his thought was like that. These attempts further angered the British, and their enmity with Tipu Sultan grew up. Actually, among all the attempts that is done during the 18th century to stop British, the effort of Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan stand due to many aspects. They knew that they can't defeat the British with their traditional arms, hence they modernized their army. The soldiers of Mysore army were capable of using modern weapons and do drills like European armies. Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan used rockets during the war at the first time in India. Apart from modern weapons, both of them knew that they needed funds in their treasury for their battles. Hyder Ali had witnessed many Nawabs going bankrupt while waging war against the British, so both of them took measures to strengthen their economic system by entering into various agreements and trade pacts. They nationalized the tobacco and sandalwood. They invited French exports to improve the quality of traditional artifacts of Mysore in order to gain better market share at international markets. This is about the Tipu Sultans and what is more about the Tipu Sultan information. In upcoming class, I am going to talk to you about more about the Anglo-Mysore War, that is third and fourth Anglo-Mysore War. Thank you for watching video. Have a great day ahead. Stay tuned to GJS.